Hey guys, I'm Laura with Rockland Technologies, your leading source on helium mining accessories and antennas. Today we're going to be clearing up some of those confusing antenna connector types and learn about gain loss and cable shielding types to determine which cable shielding is best for your situation. And at the end, we'll go over how to enter our special miner giveaway for those of you just tuning into our channel. Now, let's go to Jason, who's going to explain to us why most miners, including Rock, Nebra Indoor, and Bobcat, have a female connector, even though most connectors look like this.
Thanks, Laura. It is a major source of confusion in our live chats and phone calls, so that's why we made up these special t-shirts to help assure you that the connector on your miner is, in fact, RP-SMA female, even though it has a pin and not a hole. And that's because it's a special type of connector called RP, or reverse polarity. The gender goes by the threading, and the pin and the hole are inversed versus standard SMA. So when you're sourcing a cable for your miner, you want to make sure to get RP-SMA male, which is going to have a hole. Now that's only for the connector on your miner. When you're looking at an outdoor antenna like our 8 dBi or 4 dBi, it goes as you logically think it would. Our N female connector here has a hole, and the N male connector has a pin. Now we're going to go to John, who's going to give us a breakdown of cable shielding and why a good low loss shielding is important.
This is John, and I'm going to give a brief rundown on cable shielding and how that affects cable length. As the length of your cable increases, so does your gain loss. For a shorter pigtail, you can get away with RG316 or RG58. For medium lengths, we recommend 200 or 240. For lengths above 20 feet, we suggest 400. And if you're going with a really long cable, 600 may be ideal.
But what about the different brands of cables? We know the difference now between 200 and 400 grade, but what about the difference between Times Microwave LMR 400 and RFC 400? Well, in our years of experience, we found very, very little difference between LMR, RFC, and CFD. It's a lot like car tires, where if you look at the sizes and the specs, you're gonna come out with similar performance. There may be some small differences here or there, but overall, the LMR, RFC, and CFD are all cables we'd recommend. We'd only suggest staying away from smaller brands that are very low cost that you haven't heard of. They may sacrifice some in components and manufacturing process, which means even though they might have the same low loss off the bat, as you use them over time, they could break down and stop working.
Hey John, your shirt.
Oh, that's right. Did we tell you about our SyncroB.it Miner giveaway contest? That's right, we're giving away a free SyncroB.it miner to one lucky person. Entry is as easy as clicking that subscribe button below, but if you want to get four times as many entries, go ahead and share this video or any of our other helium related videos to the social media platform of your choice. To see the full contest rules, check out the description box below, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Happy mining.